Thank you. Thank you. Please be seated. We're here. Good afternoon. Good morning, actually, isn't it? As president of McDaniel College, I am so pleased to welcome you today to our 150th commencement ceremony. And before we start, I want to thank Dr. Glenn Caldwell, professor of music, for composing that beautiful fanfare, which was commissioned by McDaniel in celebration of our 150th anniversary. Can we please give Glenn a round of applause? So now I'm going to ask all of you in the house with the digital communication device, which will be all of you, please, you can take it out. And on behalf of all the parents here today, just please turn off your ringer. But while this device is in your hand, text, tweet, update your Facebook status, Instagram photo, and please put hashtag McDaniel20 in all of your posts. You look great out there. I'm going to post right now. Fantastic. Hashtag McDaniel20. It's got a great sound to it. And since we are in a very new space this year, how do you like being outdoors here? I encourage you to make note of our two exits to the left of the stage, to your right. They are able for you to use for emergencies. So we have the balloons here and the balloons back there. And please note, in the green tent at the back, we have emergency medical services in case you need any sort of assistance. And we are expecting some pretty high temperatures today, so I hope you got a bottle of water when you came in the stadium. And if you need some more water, you can go back to the green tent and we have it available for you. Everyone should also have received a mask, and we would ask that unless you are seated, please, in accordance with the Carroll County Health Department, that you do wear your mask. But I also have to say, boy, it feels good to have it off. And we would ask also, please, when our graduates walk across the stage, we need you to be masked as well. So now, to our graduates. On behalf of all of us here at McDaniel, I just want to say, it is marvelous to see you in three dimensions and not on a Zoom page. You know, last year, this pandemic took a lot away from us. And it took away our in-person commencement ceremony for your class. We were able to celebrate your achievements virtually, but I know how disappointed you were and how disappointed I was that you were not able to take part in many of our time-honored traditions, such as getting to cross the stage and getting to ring the old main bell. I have to be honest, of all the difficult decisions I think I've ever had to make as a college president, that was maybe the most difficult one, and I'm sorry how it impacted you. But today is a new day. I made you a promise, and we have this day to celebrate your achievements, your incredible commitment, your perseverance that got you to this very moment. So class of 2020, this is your day, and we welcome you to this ceremony. Graduates, you range in age from 18 to 63. You hail from Hawaii to Massachusetts, from California to Connecticut, from Michigan to Texas, 25 states and the District of Columbia in all. And you also hail from 10 countries, Australia, El Salvador, Latvia, Philippines, South Korea, Togo, Uganda, the United Kingdom, Zaire, and the USA. So I should be saying to you this morning, good day. Hola, Zveki, como está? Anyago haseo, bonjour, and hey y'all. You have studied in 22 countries around the world: Argentina, Australia, Austria, Bahamas, Chile, China, Costa Rica, Czech Republic, Dominican Republic, Ecuador, Egypt, England, Germany, Greece, Hungary, Ireland, Mexico, New Zealand, Peru, Scotland, Spain, and the Turks and Caicos. Your diversity of interests is reflected in your studies in 50 majors, with the top five majors being business administration, kinesiology, political science, communications, and English. One of you designed your own major, and three of you had three Jan terms apiece. You are the class of 2020. I would now like to draw your attention to these talented and regalia-clad colleagues of mine seated in the stands on the M. All of them play a critical role in the education and growth of our students and contribute to their success both inside and outside the classroom. They have been your guides, your mentors, your coaches. They have helped you explore yourselves and the world around you. They pushed you beyond your comfort zone so that you can now traverse with confidence into the unpredictable world that lies ahead. I would ask these outstanding individuals who serve on our faculty, those who serve in the administration, and the trustees of McDaniel College, could you please rise now so that we can recognize you for your exceptional work? Please stand. In the back of your program, you will find 8 pages of names of students who received awards last year for outstanding achievement or who were elected to various honor societies during the virtual senior awards ceremonies we held last spring. And I would like to officially recognize their achievements in this larger gathering. So those of you who are listed in the back, those of you who received awards last year or members of honor societies, could you please stand for a moment and let us recognize you and applaud you. Don't be bashful. I see all those cords. Congratulations. I also want to present the winners of our top student awards, beginning with our undergraduate awards. And if you happen to be present today, please stand so we can recognize you. And just hold your applause to the end, if you would. The Mary Ward Lewis Prize to the outstanding female member of the class of 2020 was awarded to Veronica Johns, who earned a bachelor's in Spanish and a master's in teaching. The Bates Prize to the outstanding male member of the class of 2020 was awarded to Ravi Patel, who was a double major in political science specializing in international studies. The Argonaut Award for the highest GPA and the Edith Farr Riddington Writing Award for the best senior paper was awarded to Nicolette Brookman, who earned a bachelor's in English with a minor in secondary education. And our graduate student award recipients were the Joan Devlin Coley Award for Excellence in Education for earning the best record as a graduate student in the study of literacy theory and practice was awarded to Sarah Grace Watcher, who earned a master's degree in reading specialist literacy leadership. The B. Jill Brooks Hodge Professional Development Award, presented to a graduate student who demonstrated academic excellence with a strong compassion for individuals with special needs and interest in serving the deaf or disabled, was awarded to Claire Francis Roberts, who earned a master's degree in deaf education. Can we give these award winners a round of applause? Our 2020 Faculty Award recipients were the Shelton Adjunct Faculty Award for Teaching Excellence, recognizing an outstanding adjunct faculty member at the graduate or undergraduate level whose teaching demonstrates a commitment to excellence and genuine care for their students, was awarded to Alana Murray, adjunct lecturer in the Equity and Excellence in Education graduate program in the Graduate and Professional Studies. The Ira G. Zepp Teaching Enhancement Grant, which encourages a significant project designed to enhance teaching, was awarded to Chloe Erla, assistant professor of art and a class of 2007 McDaniel alumna. And the Ira G. Zepp Distinguished Teaching Award, recognizing inspired classroom work and dedication to students, was awarded to Richard Smith, associate professor of sociology and also a class of 2000 McDaniel alumnus. Can we give these distinguished faculty award winners a round of applause? On this occasion, I would also like to recognize six members of our faculty community who retired last year and who were elected by our Board of Trustees as emeritus faculty. Dr. Donna Evergates, Professor of Foreign Languages and History with 33 years of service. Dr. Andrea L. Hoffman, Associate Professor of Kinesiology with 15 years of service. Dr. Eddie Laird, Associate Professor of Education with 20 years of service. Dr. Kathy Mangan, Professor of English with 43 years of service. Dr. Vasilis Pagonis, Professor of Physics with 34 years of service. And Dr. Susan Scott, Professor of Art and Art History with 19 years of service. And I would also like to take a moment to recognize six members of our community who will retire this year and have been elected by our board as emeritus faculty. And I would ask, please, if you're here today, to stand as well. Dr. Robin Armstrong, Associate Professor of Music with 26 years of service. Dr. Richard Claycomb, Professor of Economics and Business Administration with 40 years of service. Dr. Vera Jacoby, Associate Professor of Philosophy with 25 years of service. Dr. David Kreider, Senior Lecturer in Music with 40 years of service. Dr. Henry Reif, Professor of Special Education with 32 years of service. And Dr. Ethan Seidel, Professor of Economics and Business Administration with 52 years of service. Altogether, these amazing professors have given 379 years of service to McDaniel. That is exceptional work, and they deserve a hearty round of applause. Next, it is my pleasure to introduce our chair of the McDaniel College Board of Trustees, Lieutenant General retired Otto Gunther. Lieutenant General Gunther has served on our Board of Trustees since 2006 and was named board chair in 2019. He is also a 1963 alumnus and was a member of the Green Terror Battalion Army Reserve Officers Training Corps program. Following graduation, he began active duty in the United States Army and served courageously for 34 years. Lieutenant General Gunther is one of 12 military generals among the highest ranking to ever graduate from McDaniel and Western Maryland College. He has received many military awards and decorations, including the Defense Superior Service Medal, the Bronze Star, the Meritorious Service Medal, the Joint Service Commendation Medal, and in 2019 was named to the United States Army Communication Electronics Command Hall of Fame. Yesterday, Lieutenant General Gunther received yet another well-deserved honor. At yesterday's ROTC commissioning ceremony, Lieutenant Colonel Eduardo Rodriguez, Professor of Military Science and the Army ROTC Department Head here at McDaniel, unveiled a new ROTC award, the Lieutenant General Otto Gunther Leadership Award. This new award will be presented annually to the commissioning cadet who best exemplifies the character, morals, and leadership, and the lifelong dedication demonstrated by Lieutenant General Otto Gunther to both the United States Army and to his alma mater. Lieutenant General Gunther, your spirit of generosity, perseverance, and hard work has been a shining example for all of us and has positively impacted the lives of those who've come to know you. It is with great pride that we call you one of our own, and we have the chance to recognize and celebrate cadets who hold the same values that have made you an impactful leader. Congratulations to you.
Thank you, Dr. Casey. As chair of the Board of Trustees of McDaniel College, I bring greetings to you on behalf of the board. We congratulate all of you who are graduating today. Last weekend at our annual meeting, the McDaniel College Board of Trustees had the honor to present Tina Bajorkel, President Emerita of the Maryland Independent College and University Association, with an honorary Doctor of Humane Letters degree. Throughout her career, Tina has worked tirelessly to ensure access to quality education and rightfully earned the reputation of being the name, the face, and the voice of private higher education in Maryland. Her extraordinary work has opened the doors for so many well-deserving students, and it was our distinct honor to recognize her work with the awarding of an honorary degree. We will also have the opportunity this afternoon to recognize two extraordinary alumni of this college. Mary Lynn Durham, sitting right over here to my right, and her husband, who also serves as vice chair of the Board of Trustees, and Bill Raj, both members of the class of 1970. And those that have been in the upgraded student center know that it is now called the Raj Center. Mary Lynn and Bill have been strong supporters of the college, and their generosity has significantly helped us amplify our students' first mission. It will be a pleasure to recognize their service and dedication to this college and present them both with honorary Doctor of Laws degrees at this afternoon's ceremony. It is now my privilege and really a very big honor to provide the Doctor of Humane Letters recommended by the Board's Academic and Campus Life Committee and duly approved by the entire Board of Trustees to our ninth president, Dr. Roger Casey. I would like to welcome two special guests. Robin Allers, his beautiful wife, is with us here today and has been a teammate with him the entire time, and his dad, Ruskin Casey. And those that have been in the library know that the Casey Corner was named after his dad and mom. Thank you both for being here today and helping us celebrate the extraordinary work of President Casey. Dr. Roger Casey, for the past 11 years, you have brilliantly led this institution, serving as both champion of liberal arts and chief storyteller of McDaniel College. You have spent countless hours with alumni, faculty, staff, students, learning about why they love the Hill, and then traveling around the country and even the world telling their stories. Wherever you go, so too does your I Am McDaniel pin and your McDaniel College gear. You wear them with pride as you proclaim the life-changing mission of McDaniel College and the transformative power of the liberal arts education. As part of your inaugural speech in 2011, you fearlessly and boldly proclaim, it is time for McDaniel to shine in all of its brilliance above the plane of American higher education. Under your leadership, McDaniel has indeed shined over the past decade, receiving tremendous national recognitions on prestigious lists such as the Princeton Review, U.S. News and World Report, Washington Monthly, Forbes and Money Magazine. Most notably, McDaniel has been ranked as the number one best value regional university in the North in the U.S. News and World Report 2021 Best Colleges rankings for consecutive years. Roger, you have truly established yourself as an icon of higher education. You have helped secure McDaniel's place in the spotlight through your work on the national scene as chair of the National Association of Independent Colleges and Universities, NICU, board member of the American College of Education and membership of the Maryland Independent College and Universities Association, MICUA, where you served as chair from 2015 to 2019. Your commitment and focus on putting students first have led to many remarkable opportunities for our students. Under your leadership, we created the Center for Experience and Opportunity, CEO, a single office comprehensively supporting experiential learning and global fellows, a program allowing students to internationalize any major. You have overseen construction and major renovations of Gill Stadium, Engler Dining Facility, WMC Alumni Hall, Raj Student Center, McTeer Zepp Plaza, Gill Physical Education Learning Center, Hoover Library, and five residence halls, which have all helped improve the on-campus experiences of our students. Under your leadership, we have also been able to increase our focus and commitment to success and affordability through the creation of scholarships like the Educators, Military, and Alumni Legacies, which offers 100K scholarships to all children of educators, veterans, and alumni. We secured the largest scholarship request in the college's history, approximately $6 million, which funds the Dorsey Scholars Program, a full tuition, room and board scholarship for up to five students each year. These incredible initiatives led to the college's welcoming the largest and most diverse first-year class in its history over the past 2 years. You have also been a strong advocate for access and affordability in Annapolis and Washington, tirelessly working to support important programs like the Selinger Grant, which provides grants to independent colleges and allows them to provide additional need-based financial aid to Maryland students. Throughout the years, you have boldly and enthusiastically shared the story of transformative power of education. But this isn't just a message you share, it's your story too. From a young child growing up in rural South Carolina, voraciously reading your great-grandmother's 1950s encyclopedias, to being a first-generation college student, to the college presidency, your journey has been a living example of the communities and adventures that arise from education. Proudly identifying yourself as a long life learner, you make it your mission to learn something every day. As a proud Phi Beta Kappa, you have confidently stated that you have followed the society's motto, the love of learning is the guide to life. Roger, your extraordinary work has opened the doors for many first-generation and well-deserving students. It has been a privilege, and certainly my privilege, to have had you serve as McDaniel's 9th president, an even greater honor to know you. On the occasion of this 150th commencement of the college, it is my privilege to confer upon you the honorary degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, to invest you with the hood appropriate to this degree, and to welcome you into all the privileges and honors related thereto.
Dr. Casey?
A little verklempt there. Otto, members of the board, faculty and staff, fellow alumni and friends, my deepest thanks to you for this honor. equal to the accolade of receiving an honorary doctorate. And in all honesty, greater than the degree itself is the ability to now call myself an alumnus of McDaniel College. All right. So I'm one of you now, class of 20. Thank you. So what I want to know is, do I get to ring the bell? And somebody tell me where the party is, okay? So I have got a piece of paper now that finally proves I am McDaniel College. Graduates. I started your college career on the Hill at a convocation in which we shouted out, I am McDaniel College. So one more time, please, I want you to join with me in a rousing rendition of those four incredibly important words, I am McDaniel College. Please shout it out with me on the count of three, all right? One, two, three. I am McDaniel College. And you've been out of practice for a year, so one more time on the count of three. One, two, three. I am McDaniel College. Yes, we are. And we are here. As Otto said, I was the first person in my family to attend college and the first person in my extended family to earn a bachelor's degree. And there are many of you who are here today who share that distinction with me. Give it a wave if you're the first person to graduate in your family. Yeah. So you especially know what I mean when I say that this is not easy. And I'm deeply honored today to have one person in the audience who supported me and witnessed my graduation from Furman University in the early 1980s, my father, Ruskin Casey. So if you've had a cup of coffee at Casey's Corner, this is the guy that Robin and I named it to honor. Dad, thank you. Unfortunately, my mother passed away last November, and so she didn't get to see this day. But I know there are a lot of you here today who lost loved ones in this pandemic. And I share with you the extraordinary difficulty of caring for an ill family member and grieving in a pandemicized world of quarantines and social distancing. I share your grief. But we need to bracket that sadness this morning because today is a day for joy, a day for celebration with friends and loved ones. And I got to see so many friends here today, many for the first time in three dimensions in over a year. Raise your hand if you're sick of Zoom. And I also see one loved one that I have to thank publicly as well, and that is my wife of 30 years, Robin Allers. I would not be here without you, metaphorically and literally, so thank you for traveling with me on this journey. I did the math last week, I can still do it, and I realized that over the past 40 years, this morning marks the 50th college commencement ceremony, counting my own, in which I have participated. But after the year that we've just gone through, it is certainly the most special, even without this honor. It's also the only commencement ceremony I've ever attended where the graduates have already received their degrees. So unlike every other previous graduate of McDaniel or Western Maryland class of 20, you do not have to sit through a graduation speech before you get your diploma. You already have your diploma. So thank you for your patience over the next 90 minutes or so while I share some words of wisdom. Oh, I'm kidding about that, all right? I will be brief. I promise to be very brief. Your class is unique because every year since we built Gill Stadium, a group of students has approached me wanting to have their graduation ceremony outside. So to those of you who petitioned me, you sure went to a lot of trouble to get what you want, I want to say. I do not want to hear anyone complain about the heat. I mean, just be glad the cicadas aren't out yet. I mean, they waited 17 years for this day, not just one, all right? McDaniel asserts that our liberal arts curriculum educates leaders, so I have this morning just three brief pieces of leadership advice I want to share based on 30 years of progressive leadership experience. And each one of these ideas is oxymoronic. They're contradictory. If you break the word oxymoronic down into its Latin roots, oxymoronic, I think it means stupid Westerner or something like that. Oxymoronic, I think it's a great word. It means seemingly contradictory or paradoxical. The great American writer F. Scott Fitzgerald paradoxically posited that, quote, "The test of a first-rate intelligence is the ability to hold two opposed ideas in mind at the same time and still retain the ability to function." You have a McDaniel degree now. That is about as first-rate as it gets in my book. So I hope these paradoxical offerings of mine do not defunct you. And I'm going to go one step further than Fitzgerald, and I'm going to suggest that in the 21st century, you cannot function effectively as a leader in a diverse society unless you can hold two opposing minds in your mind simultaneously, and perhaps more than just two, if that is mathematically possible. Dr. Hamlin can help me with that. So I want to argue that much of the conflict in our nation now results because people, especially those who orbit D.C., seem incapable of admitting there are two or more sides to every coin. So trust me, I'm not being flippant when I flip you these paradoxical ideas that I've coined over the years that I have served as a higher education leader. My first piece of paradoxical leadership advice, make a plan. Always make a plan. And then absolutely do not follow your plan. At your age, nowhere in my future was a college presidency. Nowhere in my plan was even being a professor. Nowhere in my plan was living in Maryland. Among my plans from first grade to 30 years of age were being an astronaut, an aeronautical engineer, an orthopedic surgeon, a high school English teacher, a pastoral counselor, a stand-up comedian, and a theater director. So based on my plans, I am a complete and total failure in life. But I'm not any of those things now, yet key components of my life and career are rooted in the plans that I made to be those things. To misquote Tennyson, I am a part of all that I have planned. The Baltimore writer John Barth said, "The story of your life is not your life, it's your story. And your story has many chapters left. Plot them out so you do not wander aimlessly. And then as they are written, adapt, change, or else you will stagnate. Darwin established many years ago that the species most adaptive to change are the ones that survive. And that works for humans too. Be prepared and be spontaneous." When I was in college, people never seemed to understand when I told them, "I've got to go because I'm off to a rehearsal for my improv group." I mean, the fundamental skill of improvisation is a process called yes and. In improv, no matter what situation you're placed in, you accept it, you add to it, you make it better, or you use it to make someone laugh. It takes years of practice to master the art of going with the flow, especially when no one else realizes you're the one in charge of the current. My second piece of paradoxical leadership advice, understanding yourself is more important perhaps than anything else. And the thing you need to understand most is it's not about you. I hope your education has accomplished much in the realm of helping you understand who you are. Mine certainly did. You are indeed the playwright of the drama that is called your life. But it was working as a theater director that I learned this crucial fact about leadership. Nobody comes to the play to see the director. Success in life is a constant balancing act of taking enough care of me so that I can effectively serve you. I love the way the late Kobe Bryant put it. When Shaquille O'Neal told him, "There is no I in team," Kobe replied, "But there is an M and an E, me." He had one additional word he quoted, I won't say that. The greatest, and I'm not talking about Tom Brady, I would accept Simone Biles in that category. The true greatest of all time, Muhammad Ali, finished his commencement address to the Harvard class of 1975 with the widely attributed world's shortest poem. Quoth Ali, "Me, we." Me, we. Now, some have argued that Ali actually said, "Me, we." You know, that's pretty good advice, too, but it doesn't fit my point. As a college president, I learned pretty early in my tenure, it is impossible to get anything done in life without the help of somebody else. Every one of you has unique talents, and we are depending mightily on them to straighten out this mess of a world that too many people before you who were focused solely on me have left so out of balance. Know yourself, and then together, please change this world. Seek a vocation that enables you to do so. The theologian Frederick Buechner goes so far as to define vocation as that place where your deep gladness meets the world's deep hunger. And I feel fortunate in life I found mine. My final piece of paradoxical advice, question your truths constantly. But no, you are here on this earth to bear witness to truths. More than anything else, I hope your liberal arts education has instilled in you an insatiable curiosity quest, an unceasing, compelling need to know what is the truth. Some pundits have wagged that we now live in a post-truth age. I want to state this unequivocally. There is no such thing as an alternative fact. There are only people deluded by the worst pandemic our society faces today. It is not COVID. It is stupidity. What is my definition of stupidity? What is my definition of stupidity? Well, Ralph Waldo Emerson said it far more tactfully when he wrote, quote, "A foolish consistency is the hobgoblin of little minds." Foolish consistency. I want you to question authority. Question yourself. Question everything. Do not accept unchallenged assumptions, especially off the internet. But also, do not let your questioning drive you down the rabbit hole of never believing in anything. What's that old saying? You've got to stand for something or you will fall for anything. So when you assert your well-founded belief, especially in our present world, I'm also going to promise you one more thing. Someone is going to criticize you for it. Someone is going to challenge you. Even Taylor Swift knows this. The haters gonna hate, 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 hate. I think I got that right. You know, right after he wrote that foolish consistency quote, Emerson finished his paragraph with this line, "To be great is to be misunderstood." Inevitably, doing the right thing, bearing witness to hard truths, is going to get you in trouble. It has done that my entire life. It is going to get you misunderstood. But I hope, to use the language of the late Congressman John Lewis, it will get you into good trouble. Good trouble. I have been so moved that so many members of your generation and so many of you took to the streets last year in the wake of a pandemic, in the wake of the killing of George Floyd and so many countless others. You took to the streets and you said to this nation and you said to the world, this is enough. Black lives matter. Your bearing witness led to a long overdue wave of change across this country. It has led to a wave of change that is ongoing at this college. You know, I suspect everyone in this audience has heard the name George Floyd. But how many of you know the name of Darnella Frazier? I'm going to ask, do you know who Darnella Frazier is? Darnella Frazier was the 17-year-old young woman who stood in the face of authority and captured the cell phone footage of Mr. Floyd's death and put it on Facebook, an act of bearing witness that led to the world taking to the streets. Or consider another case, Malala Yousafzai, now 23, who 10 years ago nearly gave her life for bearing witness about the truth of the Taliban and their attitudes toward women and education. Yes, the truth will set you free, but it will never set you on an easy path. But I believe here at McDaniel, we have prepared you well for the sojourn. The next step is yours. So in conclusion, make a plan. And at the right point, throw it away. Take care of your me so that you can do a lot of good for the we. And quest for truth so that you can bear witness to a world that needs the light. McDaniel has learned so much from knowing you. Our world has so much to gain from your lives ahead. It has been an honor to serve you as your president. Me, we. I am McDaniel, we are McDaniel. And in the words of our Latin motto, I call you out of darkness and into the light. So go out there and shine brightly. Thank you. So before we move to the awarding of degrees, I want to take a moment to note some changes that have been made to our process this year to ensure the safety of our staff, students, and our honored guests. Typically during this portion of the ceremony, we would be inviting our students forward, we would have them walk across the stage, and I would have the privilege of handing you your diploma and shaking your hand. But unfortunately, COVID-19 restrictions prevent us from doing that last part. So in just a few moments, at the direction of our marshals, the students will be invited forward and will have the chance to process across the stage. They will pick up their diploma tube from the table right behind me, and then they will process the rest of the way across the stage. We don't get to shake your hand this year, but we're going to be here clapping and congratulating you as you make your way down the steps for your photograph in front of the McDaniel College banner. So, let's get on with the moment you've been waiting for. On with the degrees, Dr. Mazur.
Mr. President. Traditionally, each master's candidate would be hooded individually as they come to the stage for their diploma. The hooding is a visible recognition of the student's achievement of an advanced degree. However, today, to mitigate potential health risks associated with individual hooding, our master's candidates have been asked to enter the stadium with their hoods on. However, we would like to take a moment now to collectively honor their achievement by symbolically hooding one of the master's candidates on behalf of the graduate class of 2020 prior to the walking the stage. The origins of the academic dress date back to the 12th and 13th centuries. The regalia is a visible reminder that the process of intellectual pursuit has historic and honorable antecedents. Academic attire consists of gowns, hoods, and caps designed to honor and recognize various levels of degree attainment. The bachelor's gown falls in straight lines and has long pointed sleeves, while the sleeves for the master's gown are closed with slits for the arms at the wrist. The doctor's gown has velvet facing and three velvet bars on bell-shaped sleeves. The black mortarboard cap with four sides is most commonly worn by bachelor's and master's candidates, while those awarded the doctoral degree most commonly wear an eight-sided tam. Typically, candidates also receive a hood, which symbolizes the level of achievement by the hood's length. The bachelor's hood is 3 feet long, a master's is 3.5 feet long, and the doctoral hood is typically 5 feet in length. The colors of the velvet bands on each hood represent the scholar's degree, while the official colors of the school awarding the degree are always shown in the lining of the hood. McDaniel's colors are green, yellow, and white. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, President, Provost, Deans, and our faculty, McDaniel would like to recognize the master's candidates of the class of 2020 for your advanced academic achievement. Congratulations and job well done. Marshall, can you please hood the candidate? Candidates for the degree of Master of Science, will you please stand and remain in place? Mr. President, I have the honor to present these candidates for the degree of Master of Science.
By the authority of the Board of Trustees of McDaniel College delegated to me, I confer upon you the degree of Master of Science, admitting you to all the rights and privileges appertaining to such degree. In testimony whereof, I present you the diploma of the college, invest you with the hood appropriate to the degree, and welcome you into the fellowship of the alumni of this academic community.
Please be seated and come forward at the direction of the marshals. Andrew Austin Adami. Amy Beal. Sherry Nyasha Burton. Sorry. Alexis Dominique Bush. Nina V. Shervenkov. Catherine Mary Coffey. Natasha Sherelle Costley. Michelle Lynn Grabsky. Daniel James Graham. Kimberly Renee Graham. Chelsea Ray Green. Brooke Hall. Casey Harmon. Carlos Instans. Megan Jacobs. Crystal Brigman Johnston. Peyton Lee Lagasse. Geneva Louise Monroe. Cross Okereke. Alexandra M. Pena. Rebecca Plaitez. Elizabeth Whittier Shanklin Selby. Christine Christine Marie Stratemeyer. Lena Gail Williamson. Congratulations to all of our graduates.
Congratulations. At this time, we will move to awarding the Bachelor of Arts degrees. So as a reminder, we will follow the same safety protocols just used to award our master's candidates. So at the direction of the marshal, students will be invited forward to process across the stage. Pick up your diploma tube from this table, and I've learned an important thing, you should pick it up from the bottom half. And process the rest of the way across the stage, and we'll stand ready to congratulate you.
Candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts will please stand and remain in place. Mr. President, I have the honor to present these candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts.
By the authority of the Board of Trustees of McDaniel College delegated to me, I confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Arts, admitting you to all the rights and privileges appertaining to such degree. In testimony whereof, I present you with the diploma of the college and welcome you into the fellowship of the alumni of this academic community.
I ask the class of 2020 to come forward at the direction of the marshals. Caitlin Elena Allen, cum laude. Dylan Joseph Amos. Victoria Ann Arcelisi, cum laude, honors in communication. Justin Touch Archer, cum laude, Dorsey Scholar. Lauren Elizabeth Baum, summa cum laude, honors in art. Lauren Elise Beckjord, summa cum laude, college scholar, honors in art, Phi Beta Kappa. Paige Karen Blyer, magna cum laude. Colin D. Breidenbach. Chase M. Bushman. Haley Hina Aya Oyi Chan. Frederick W. Chase IV. Caitlin Michelle Clausen, cum laude. Alexis Marie Camo, cum laude. Antonio Carlo Di Castro. Monica Nicole Dewberry. Catherine Ann Donia, magna cum laude. Devin Allen Duval. Lucero Espinal. Jacqueline Christine Farenholz, magna cum laude, honors in environmental studies. John M. Farquharson. Aiden J. Finnerty. Tracy Ann H. Fleming, summa cum laude, McDaniel employee. Alexander Benson Fondersmith. Rachel Ann Fox, magna cum laude, honors in environmental studies. Justin Nicholas Frock. Weston Douglas Funk, summa cum laude, honors in cinema, honors in English. Nashan Amar Godfrey. Molly Byrne Goff. Cavante J. Green. Zuri A. Haley Robbins. Sarah Elizabeth Hegna. Megan Hope Henderson, cum laude, college scholar. Abigail J. Hernandez, cum laude, honors in psychology. Madison Nicole Hively, magnum cum laude. Kaylee Ann Hollinger, magna cum laude, Phi Beta Kappa, college scholar, honors in biology. Taylor Camille Holmes. Emily Nicole Hauska. Suyoung Jun, cum laude. Madison L. Johnson, summa cum laude. Triana Tasha Cecilia Johnson. Michael Charles Kara. Allison Gail Keller, cum laude, honors in communication. David Jong Pyung Kim. Makias Bakaley Kisi. Jensen Lois Koontz. Frank Michael Cradiville III, summa cum laude, college scholar, honors in philosophy. Caitlin Alexandra Lamb. Kathia Marie Lamort. Stuart Lachlan Landis. Nicholas Julie Lavery. Yeah. Jonathan Michael Ling, McDaniel employee and son of McDaniel employee, Corporal Michael Ling. Sarah F. Mahmood. Amber Tony McDonald. Emily M. McQuarrie. Isabella Mandiola, summa cum laude. Emily Irene Metzger. Janelle Meyer. Olivia Grace Michelle. Nathan Ryan Miller, cum laude, Phi Beta Kappa. Anna Claire Mondereau, magna cum laude, Phi Beta Kappa, honors in cinema. Kristen Praise Murphy. Jeb Stewart Nicholas Myers, cum laude, Phi Beta Kappa, honors in political science and international studies. Olivia Mackenzie Knoll. Matthew Frank Andre Orgozalik. Olivia Josephine Palmery. Benjamin Andrew Piggott. Natalie Grace Quigley. Hannah Susan Ravenscroft, magna cum laude, Phi Beta Kappa. Casey Catherine Reese, summa cum laude, honors in social work. Kirsten Lynn Reed. Catherine Elizabeth Rickrode, magna cum laude. Thomas L. Redo. Timothy Rigg Jr., cum laude. Kamari M. Robinson. Haley Nicole Rust. Raya Elizabeth Rutherford. Megan Nicole Sadler, magna cum laude, Phi Beta Kappa, college scholar, honors in biology. Janae Amani Sanz, cum laude. Megan Schlesinger, magna cum laude. Christina Ann Shank. Colleen M. Sheckles. Kevin C. Sheckles. Megan J. Sheckles. Jill Catherine Shepherd, magna cum laude, Phi Beta Kappa, college scholar, global fellows. Elise Marie Simons. Onisha Novena Smith, cum laude, honors in philosophy. Benjamin Graham Stapleton. Desiree Kirsten Sweeney, magna cum laude. Jacob Lyle Stapleton. Andrew Miller Stone. William Alexander Strauss. Natalie Marie Tolley. Domonice Tonita Taylor. Miranda Danielle Thompson. Magna cum laude. Donovan Taylor. Miranda Danielle Thompson. Allie M. Titus, magna cum laude. John Thomas Uller. Vanessa Velez Cabal, cum laude. Abigail Rose Watcher. Connor Ryan Wiekert. Elizabeth Charlene Wilson. Jamie Allison Wimmer, magna cum laude. Madeline Perry Wodowski, magna cum laude. Kyle Wayne Wolfrey, cum laude, honors in communication. Kyle Dylan Wyant. Jessica Morgan Wyatt, cum laude. Daniela Yacobucci Lapatis, Global Fellow, Honors in Art. Joseph Robert Yankowski, Honors in Philosophy. Joe Yerby III. Andrew Sherrick Zimmel.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the McDaniel Class of 2020. Thank you very much. Although they can't be with us today because most of them are on active duty, but I want to take a moment to recognize 9 graduates from the class of 2020 who received commissions into the United States Army through ROTC last year. If any of them are here, please stand so we can recognize you. Second Lieutenant Andre Alexander Berry, Second Lieutenant Joseph Bigot, Second Lieutenant William Frederick Bauer, Second Lieutenant Ethan David Cortez, Second Lieutenant Grace Elise Natowski, Second Lieutenant Carson S. Marshall, Second Lieutenant Andrew Jordan Murphy, Second Lieutenant Cross Okereke, Second Lieutenant Caleb DeRoy White. Let's congratulate these second lieutenants and thank them for their service. Cross, thank you. Memorial Day is just over a week away, and I would like us to take a moment to remember and honor all those military personnel who lost their lives in the service of their country. Would you join me in a moment of silence? Thank you. And while we are honoring people who have sacrificed for our benefit and well-being, I want each one of our graduates to look around you and to recognize people that you all owe gratitude and appreciation to. The parents, grandparents, sponsors, husbands, wives, aunts, uncles, guardians, children of our graduates. Shout out their praises. Show them how much they mean to you. I want these unsung heroes who are your friends to stand up and you to applaud them and recognize them for their support. Thank you. You would not have this ceremony today were it not for the extraordinary work of numerous individuals at this college who have spent all year trying to plan this exercise, created this magnificent environment today, and have volunteered their time. Would we please give a round of applause for all those who've led this magnificent effort? At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce the president of the McDaniel College Alumni Association, Chuck Sullivan, class of 1972. Chuck?
The McDaniel Alumni Association was formed in 1872. Since its inception, the Alumni Association has played a significant role in engaging McDaniel alumni with the mission of the campus, organizing networking and mentoring opportunities, and celebrating alumni achievements around the world. As it says in our alma mater, we'll be ever loyal to thee. On behalf of the McDaniel College Alumni Association, I welcome each of you into the Alumni Association. In recognition of your alumni status, a gift has been placed under your chairs. Congratulations to you, the newest McDaniel alums. We proudly welcome you into your Alumni Association. We have you now. You are McDaniel. We're Green Terriers for life.
Wear those tags with pride. We would generally conclude this happy occasion of the 150th commencement of McDaniel by singing our alma mater, but this year, unfortunately, COVID-19 restrictions prevent us from doing so. Instead, we will conclude our ceremony by listening to the alma mater being sung and taking the opportunity to truly reflect on its words. Following the alma mater, our students will process out of the stadium. I would ask all of our guests to please remain seated until the entire recessional is complete. And afterwards, I have a special request. Please reunite with your graduate outside the stadium and congratulate them on their incredible achievements out there. Or continue your celebration downtown at one of the many fantastic restaurants here in Westminster. The celebration for our class of 2021 happens on this very field this afternoon, and on behalf of those incredibly hardworking commencement volunteers, they have to reset the stage and the field for that ceremony. So I would ask you to please not congregate on the field. Would you all please rise for our alma mater? Thank you.